Hallelujah, glory to God. You're welcome to Prophetic Intercession with Amel. Someone is watching you. Someone is observing you and they think you are crazy. They see your countenance. They see how you pray. They see how you seek God. And they think you are crazy. They think they know a little about you because they see how you behave, maybe in the presence of God, and they think you're crazy. They think they understand your pain, or they think they know your pain, or they think they could handle it better, but they have no idea what you are going through. They have no idea how it feels to be in your position. They say that there is an adage that says, uneasy it lies the head that wears the crown. You are the one who knows where the issue is pinching you. You are the one who knows how much that is costing you. And so like Hannah, you don't have to pay attention to what they think while you are seeking God. You don't have to pay attention to what they think while you are praying to God. And the prophet Eli told Hannah, How is it that you are drunk at this early hour of the day? And she said, no, I am not drunk. She was praying before her maker. She was crying before her God. She had been seeking for a child and a child was not forthcoming. And so that day she decided to pray and groan in tongues. And it seemed like she was drunk, but she was just pouring out her pain and her frustration before God. Even the priest could not understand her. But it did not stop her from groaning in the presence of the Lord. And of course, God heard her prayer. When your answered prayer comes, everyone will join you to celebrate. Even the people who thought you were crazy by praying the way you did, by seeking God the way you did, even the people who judged you, they said you were doing too much, they are going to join you to celebrate if they are not jealous of you, because eventually your Samuel will arrive. Hallelujah, glory to God. Your Samuel will arise. You will arrive. And the Bible says there has been no prophet like Samuel because his words did not fall to the ground. That is an answered prayer. That is what the prayer of someone did. So do not look at the faces of people when you are groaning before God. Do not look at the faces of people when you are seeking the Lord, when you want something from Him. Do not try to think of who thinks what. How do I look like? Do I look presentable?